kind of tone of dance. Welcome to round number two. Thanks to everybody for joining us.
Yeah, we've got an energy mirror match.
Very energetic match right here.
Anybody who has been paying attention to Standard for any amount of time knows that this happens quite frequently.
A non-zero number of matches.
A non-two number of matches.
Correct.
A non-infinite number of matches.
It's not infinite as well.
Look at that. We're just throwing facts out.
Facts. It better be factually correct than correct.
Yeah.
So on the left, Bobby Colgrove playing a four-color energy deck. He earned the buy last round.
Very interesting to see what version of this four-color energy deck he's in, by the way. Sorry, go on.
And by earned, I mean was randomly awarded.
Marquis de Sad Boy.
Marquis de Sad Boy? Interesting.
Thank you.
Thanks for the follow.
Yeah.
And Jon Tople playing a pretty stock Temur energy list.
I would assume. Have you seen it?
Yeah, I've looked over his shoulders. There's no surprises.
No surprises. So this four-color energy deck has kind of shifted. At the start of the format, it was Temur energy splashing black for Scarab God. And then it became Sultai energy splashing red for
Harness Lightning?
Harness Lightning.
So we'll see where we're at. What level are we on?
He definitely looks like the Temur energy splashing black for Scarab God currently.
Here's a forest. Nice forest start.
You like that forest start?
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Pretty good.
I like...
I wonder if you scan that with a barcode scanner, what would come up?
I really like forests with parallel trees.
Okay.
So, turn one, attune into turn two, Servant of the Conduit has to be one of the better 1-2s there is. Especially against a deck showing you red mana, like you've got to contend with a Braid. I mean, Long Tusk Cub does not survive in a Braid with just an attune to back it up.
It does not.
So I like Servant.
Servant seems pretty good.
Let's see what Tople has for us. Looks like he has a Rogue Refiner.
Yeah, here we go. Fire up the energy counter.
Draws a card. Calls it even. Here's Planeswalker off the top of the deck for Bobby.
Well, maybe I spoke too soon because I do see a Glint Sleeve Siphoner in Bobby's deck.
There's some serious energy generation. He's not going to have a problem with that.
Well, he didn't draw a third land, so he needs it somewhere.
Oh, yeah. Third land's going to go a long way here.
A Bristling Hydra. This is going to be tough to beat, although he only has the 5 energy right now.
Here's a Mountain, and I think he drew a Glorybringer. So Glorybringer could do some serious work here, only costing him 1 energy to get it into play. And once you've done that, it'll cost him 2 because you can't make any mana with the servants without the energy.
All right, so we're going to take down this Rogue Refiner, and we're going to have to stare down this Hydra still.
The Bristly Boy.
Now the Bristly Boy is going to get 2 activations with which to protect itself. This is pretty interesting because I know Bobby has a Chandra in hand.
Right.
So if he had, like, Chandra plus removal spell before, he could have taken down this Hydra. But now he's going to be reliant on probably just racing it. Well, I guess you've got enough creatures on the ground to gum it up pretty well for him.
Yeah, if he were to draw, like, you know, a couple more lands here, he could definitely turn these servants into just some rando blockers.
Jablomi asks how many people are in the PPTQ. We've got 37.
37 today.
37.
So that makes it a full 6 rounds.
Not at once.
Just over the cusp.
Not at once. 37 individuals.
Correct.
It looks like I see a Vizier in hand for Bobby as well.
Yeah, this could do some serious... Wow.
No, sir.
That's a swing right there.
No, sir.
So let's see if he's going to play this Glint Sleeve Siphoner.
Just swinging.
Oh, he's just going to bang in for four. That,
so he's got a Hydra in hand.
Yeah.
And Hydra on defense always beats Hydra on offense.
It does?
Yeah, because it's got the extra power.
Okay, so you just trade off.
Right. It's very difficult to outgrow an opposing Hydra.
Right.
So now with this Glorybringer untapping... No, it's going to untap for the wrong person.
Yep, that's going to be a big swing here. So here's a fourth land.
Draws the swamp. That's good.
So Chandra here can take down his own Glorybringer, which is not ideal, but it puts Planeswalker on the board for you, which really changes how Tople has to manage the match.
Yeah, if Tople gets to untap with Bobby's Glorybringer... chances are Bobby is not going to win that match.
Yep. Here's a Chandra. Let's see if he's going to take down the Glorybringer. Yep.
Gotta do what you gotta do.
Well, it's more like he traded... Yeah, I guess it's like one for one there, kind of. And he's going to go to one blocker. So if Tople has any piece of removal for the Servant, Chandra's not going to last long.
Well, so that's a trade-off. So you get him to spend removal on the Servant... And then you get him to attack the Chandra instead of you, which you're at 9. That's 2 swings of this Hydra.
Right.
So.
Rogue Refiner on the board for Tople.
Rogue Refiner is going to give him an extra couple of energy and an extra card. He still needs one more energy to get the third activation on this Hydra, although the third activation is much less important than the second.
Correct.
Swing in.
He's going to attack Bobby, so that's
if I'm Bobby, I'm just taking this. I don't care how many counters you put on it, I'm taking it.
So I think...
I would have gotten punished. Oh, draws the Harness Lightning. Is it too late, though?
Interesting. So... Chandra adding mana here is going to be kind of a big deal because
yeah, he's got 7,
so he's going to be able to cast 2 spells this turn, which matters.
Absolutely. I could see Chandra plus to play out a Vizier copying a Whirler Virtuoso being pretty good here.
Oh, I like that.
And then you keep 2 mana open for the Harness Lightning.
Right. That all you would have to tap there is a...
Oh, opting instead to
deal get 2 a card. Damage. I'm wondering if there was a card in Bobby's deck that that gets him out of this sticky situation that he was hunting. He just doesn't see an opening otherwise?
Hard to see. So, you're definitely under the gun here. Yikes.
Alright, so here's a Harness Lightning targeting Whirler Virtuoso. Let's see how many Thopters Tople wants to make before this dies. You're gonna make 2 Thopters. Here's a Glint Sleeve. And so now he can double block the Hydra, untap, play his own Hydra.
That's true.
So that's an opening that he's created for himself. And
but these 2 Thopters are very much a threat. Like, they're going to be able to take down this Chandra this turn. And then it's only a few turns until... they're threatening his life total as well.
Right.
It looks like John has another Hydra anyway. So I'm sure he would be very happy to trade the only 2 creatures on Bobby's board for this Hydra.
Absolutely. do you play out the... If he plays out the other Hydra first, Bobby's not even going to offer the trade.
No, no, no. I would send the two Thopters at Chandra, the two creatures at Bobby.
All right.
We get the Cub as well. This is...
Yeah, just an empty board.
Not looking great for Bobbo.
Yeah,
he doesn't have the green mana to cast the Cub. That's good news, at least. Draws a Glorybringer. Probably too little too late here.
Minus one, plus three to get his own Hydra into play. That's not going to be enough. I guess Hydra blocks Hydra. He still takes five, putting him to one. And then he has to have just the biggest turn.
Just the biggest turn.
The biggest turn you can imagine.
It would need to be two lands and a River's Rebuke.
River's Rebuke is a sweet sideboard card you see out of these teams.
Yeah, I think we're going to see it here. I think we're going to see it at least for Temur. Bobby's four-color energy sideboard might be a little too cluttered to include multiple copies of a River's Rebuke, but... Hopefully he stuck one in there.
This deck is diverse, this four-color energy deck. I mean, he's got Glintsleep Siphoners, and he's got the double blue and Vizier and double red and Glorybringer. So he's...
Double green and
Hydra.
Hydra.
Yeah, he's going deep on...
Yeah, it's not a very good mix, but man, is it powerful if you can run on all cylinders.
Yeah, the other thing you noted there was he had three basics in play and no fast lands.
Yeah.
I'm assuming that getting Blossoming Marsh, Spirebluff Canal, and Botanical Sanctum into play are
helps
all
that a lot, yeah.
pretty big deals in this four-color energy deck.
And again, we see in this energy deck, it operates much better when you can attune with Aether early.
Yeah, he had the turn one attune to smooth it a little bit, but... He would have loved the second one.
As many as you can get.
Just turns one, two, and three just attune. Would you attune on turn one and twice on turn two? Would that be a...
Oh, yeah, absolutely. If I had three attunes, sure.
You keep that hand?
Yeah.
All right. Noted.
It would, my first hand or card in hand had to have been like a Fastland or something. Like, I'm not going to keep attune...
Forest,
and then two more tunes, and just a tune for a forest. Like, that would be maddening. Not doing that.
Not doing that. Not interested. But, like, Botanical Sanctum, a tune.
So, if I had three attunes
and
a Botanical Sanctum, I would absolutely get a forest with the first one.
Sure.
Because sometimes you just need to fatal push something. I'm talking from my perspective in, like, a four-color Assault High
right.
list.
Yeah, I think it's interesting, the four-color decks, it kind of reminds me of the end of the cons format.
Oh, yeah.
Where you had the fetches and the fetchable two-color lands.
Yeah, it was...
And so it was like, okay, are you Mardu green, or are you Ebzan blue, or, like, you know, all these decks had, like, different names. So just these four-color energy is a much better, wider banner to be right. able to put these super diverse four-color decks in under than try and really identify what's going on. When you're playing against them, though, you really have to identify what's going on. You have to figure out what that deck's plan is.
Absolutely. And I think we saw from Bobby's deck there, once Jonathan saw the Glintsleeve Siphoner.
Yeah.
That is a pretty clear sign that your opponent is going to be on more of the tempo than the mid-range plan.
Sure.
Which is kind of the difference between Sultai and Temur. Sultai plays more of a tempo game. Some early drops that generate incremental value like Long Tusk Cub or Glintsleeve Siphoner. Ways to protect it with Blossoming Defense and some cheap interaction. Whereas the Temur Energy deck just tries to go bigger and wider and it's very much a mid-range deck.
Sure. All right, so Bobby on the play here. Let's see what happens. Looks like he's got at least two lands. Here's a mountain and a pass.
I see three. But I don't see a forest.
Here's a negate off the top, so we know that he's got that possibility.
Yeah, I don't really care for negate in the energy mirror.
So, I think it's very good if you're playing a tempo deck.
Yeah.
Because it can... It provides a cheaper counter than it does than the cost of whatever you're negating. I imagine his favorite card to negate here would be Confiscation Coup. Followed closely by any Planeswalker. Oh, man, and there's Vraska.
Yeah, Bobby's Vraska hand. Out of the four colors. That's exciting. That's nice. I think negate specifically is not good because the cards you're negating, like Confiscation Coup, potential Rivers Rebuke, things like that, while they do make a big impact on the board, mm-hmm. aren't like the end of the world for you because most of your creatures aren't gigantic. So like a Confiscation Coup is not a huge deal.
Sure.
I don't even know if I'd bring it in, honestly. Like you want to get their Scarab God, but that's about it. But I like Essence Scatter a lot. Essence Scattering a Glorybringer is the best way to kill a Glorybringer. A little late on this attune.
That's all right. I don't hate it.
You don't?
So, turn four I don't think is the most important turn in the Temur Energy deck. I don't mind having a second turn three.
Well, he didn't do anything on turns one and two, which makes turn three very important.
Right, but he cast Rogue Refiner on turn three, and so now he's going to have turn three again, basically, after this attune. And it guarantees whatever his turn five is going to be. Guarantees that that's going to be awesome.
The Dueling Whirler Virtuosos.
Bobby's hand is so full. He's got a Confiscation Coup and a Vraska. In his
swing
hand.
Swing with the Virtuoso. So I would have swung with the Virtuoso first.
Okay.
And then you could have... I don't know why I didn't swing here. If he blocks, you get to Harness Lightning, hit the opposing Virtuoso for one.
One less. Two less.
So and that gives you an extra Thopter.
Sure. Nuanced play there.
Yeah, there's a lot of small nuanced plays in this energy deck, especially in the mirror. And you really have to take advantage of them in order to be successful.
Here's a forest off the top, and that makes 6 mana for his Vraska. I imagine he'll pump the brakes on casting that so that he can jam it through with this negate for sure. Or have negate up, he's got Glorybringer can take down Vraska pretty easily. I guess it goes up to 6.
So there isn't really a good target for Vraska's ability on the battlefield right now.
Uh-huh.
So there's no sense in running it out there right this second. You'll let him spend some mana, trade off 1 life for 2 life over and over again. You'll take that all day. Rogue Refiner is a good one to test the waters with.
Concur.
Looks like the draw was a Vizier.
And Whirl of Virtuoso stays back again. Interesting.
I think Bobby's just a little enamored with the idea of being the control deck here.
Well, given his hand, I don't blame him.
Yeah, but even as a control deck, you have to get in there.
Sure.
Bring in the glory.
Well, we found a target for this Confiscation Coup. Harness Lightning plus 1 energy.
There's the negate.
Meets a negate. Now the Glorybringer is coming in. It's going to exert itself onto the Whirler Virtuoso. We'll have some Thopter on Thopter Violence to clear those up.
Never like seeing that. So we have an Exerted Glorybringer. Here's a Vraska.
And taking down the Glorybringer is going to be its first order of business, yeah?
Feels pretty good, I would imagine. I don't know if you have to do it right away, because it's exerted anyway.
Oh, sure. So he gets a turn of just making the pirate. Let's put Vraska up on the board. He's got a lot of activated abilities.
Thank you for the follow, MTG gentlemen.
What a nice name compared to the other names that are in the chat right now.
I don't know what you're talking about. Vraska Relic Seeker. Plus two ability is going to create a 2/2 Menace Pirate.
Yep.
Minus one is destroy artifact, creature, enchantment, and get a treasure. And minus 10, target player's life becomes one. I don't imagine we're going to see that. But we're only a turn away from that. So it's very possible.
Yeah. And with so many, like, incidentals.
Oh, here's a Vizier of Many Faces.
Copying this Glorybringer. Okay, so it's not going to exert. So now we have a bigger issue. We can... Oh, no, this is going to be sweet. So he's going to attune with Aether and be able to Confiscation Coup the Vizier of Many Faces, mm-hmm. and Vraska down the Glorybringer. I think is the way you want to do it. You definitely don't want to kill the Vizier of Many Faces so he can come back as a Glorybringer.
Right. He has a Vizier of his own. And the front side of Vizier only costs one blue, right?
I think it's 3 and 2 blue. We're going to pull up Vizier. Lots of cards on here to think about.
Definitely kill the Glorybringer. That's where we're going to have to start.
He's going to get a treasure. Okay, so we could use the treasure for the other blue here.
Sure.
No, we'll just get... We'll tune the deck up here.
Now, this is smart because this lets you back your Confiscation Coup up with...
Negate.
Oh, no, he's not getting the island.
Yeah, I wonder if he just doesn't have a second island.
That's entirely possible.
All right. The conversation is definitely targeting this Vizier. Let's see what Tople has to say about it.
He says no.
Negate it is. So now it's a race. We've got a Vizier, which is a Glorybringer, racing against a Pirate and a Rogue Refiner.
Tople with a double blue mana spell in hand.
It's a Vizier. I'm sorry.
Bobby with the double blue mana spell in hand and only one island to cast it with.
Yep. Yeah, you have to imagine he would have gotten the island if there was one in the deck.
Yeah,
because he's flush on green. He's got two green already.
Three.
Well, three now that he got the forest, right. But...
All right, so we've got some dead Rogue Refiners, dead Vraskas. That's another blue land.
Going to come in tapped. But this Rogue Refiner is going to show us a card off the top. Hopefully it's a Whirl of Virtuoso, so that would be a...
Oh, another Confiscation Coup.
Big hit. Got to attack this pirate because it sure ain't blocking. Bobby's down to 10, I believe.
Yeah, Bobby's at 10. Still in this game.
And Topple's at 8. Let's Let's see what happens next. Green, green. Cycle. We're talking about our favorite lands in Standard and...
Just my favorite lands, period.
I love lands that are spells, that act like spells.
Yeah.
The Ramunap Ruins deck, you know, has a lot of lands that act like spells. And these cycle lands definitely act like a spell. This Exerted Vizier is going to take down the new Rogue Refiner. And put Bobby to six. So let's see. We've got Confiscation Coup for one of the... So you're going to Confiscation Coup the one that's going to untap next turn.
Right.
And then yours will untap before his. But it's noteworthy that you can't use one of these Glory Bringers on a Glory Bringer. It's a non-dragon, as we learned last game.
So unless Tople has a response to the Confiscation Coup or an answer for an opposing Glory Bringer, this means he's just dead.
Here's a Vizier.
Comes in for six. So on Jonathan's attack, he's going to get to untap one of these Glory Bringers.
Yep.
Kill a pirate if he wants. Probably has to. And deal four damage.
So let's see if he's going to take all six here. Puts him to two. And here is Servant of the Conduit.
Servant of the Conduit's going to be a big deal. It's going to let him keep up negate while Confiscation Cooing.
So he's going to defeat the Exerted Glorybringer so that he can bring it back. Oh, wow. That was a tight play.
And now he gets to exert.
Well, he gets to embalm.
Sorry.
This Vizier, copying the Vizier that is a Glorybringer.
Did it. Found the way. And there we go.
Man, that's a real heads up play from Jon Tople there, just to take that one.
He had to have taken the unexerted one so that Jonathan didn't get to untap with the one that he didn't take.
Right.
But doesn't matter anyway.
So the five color energy deck, or the four color energy deck, looked real clunky there.
Yeah, it had a ton of mana problems, and I imagine there's some number of games where you're just going to.
Not be able to cast all the spells.
Yeah, I mean, that's all you can do. So that's it for round two. Temur Energy takes it down, despite Temur Energy losing in round one. We're going to figure out what else is in the room. We've got a lot of decks here. We're going to get the rest of them and talk about that a little bit next round, as well as bring you some more tepid standard action.
Can't wait to see you guys back.